Hey everybody, welcome back to the studio. So today I want to talk about something that is finally being accepted in the photography world. It's been something in the business world that's happened for years, but photographers have seemed really reluctant to get into it. What is that? Well, it's going out and getting yourself a mentor. So first of all, what is a mentor? Well, I don't call myself a mentor, I call myself a teacher. But a mentor is basically that. They're someone who has already traveled the path that you're about to travel, and they're going to teach you what you need to know, where you need to go, and the things that are going to work and not work because of their experience. Now, first, let me say something before I even get into this. A mentor is not someone who started the business 6 months ago or a year ago. They don't know anything more than what you know. They may be more successful than you, but they're probably struggling through the same things that you are, if not even more things. A mentor is somebody who's had years of experience, who's seen the ups and has seen the downs. A mentor is somebody who has fought those battles, and they know what battles to fight and what battles that they should just be ignored. The mentor that you hire should be somebody that you can trust and that has the experience that you need. So if you're in the photography business and you're doing weddings, you should find a mentor that is in the photography business and doing weddings. There's no sense hiring a mentor that is doing glamour photography if you're a wedding photographer. There's no sense hiring a mentor that is in the manufacturing business if you're in the photography business. There's no sense hiring a mentor who does nature and wildlife photography if you are a portrait photographer. Very few things cross over, and the experience that you want is in your area. You don't want general experience. You want somebody who can direct you down the right path. Another way to look at a mentor is like this. It's like going out and hiring a guide if you're hiking. If you're hiking and you want to go into an area you've never been in before, and you want to know where the best views are, where the best campsites are, where the best fishing spots are, whatever, you go out and hire somebody who knows the area. You don't go and hire somebody that lives 3,000 miles away and has never been to that area. You go out and hire somebody who's familiar with that area. That's what a mentor should be. Now, what should a mentor do and what shouldn't a mentor do? Well, first thing is, a mentor is not a staff person. A mentor is not somebody who's going to do the work for you. A mentor is not somebody that's going to go to wedding shows and man your booth. That's a salesperson. That's somebody who's going to sell for you. You hire those people, you pay those people, and they do what you tell them. A mentor is somebody that you bounce ideas off of. Whether you meet with them weekly, bi-weekly, monthly, whatever it is, you sit down with them either in person or online. I do most of mine online now. And you bounce ideas off of them. You ask them questions. You say, hey, there's 5 wedding shows coming up next month. Do you think I should go on all 5? You go, hey, when are the wedding shows? Well, they're all on Sundays. Well, there's only 4 Sundays next month. So how are you going to do 5 wedding shows if there's only 4 Sundays? Do you have a person to man the booth? Oh, I never thought about that. Are you shooting weddings on any of those Saturdays? Well, yeah, I'm shooting weddings on 2 Saturdays. Are you going to have the energy to do a wedding? Oh, I never thought of that. That's what a mentor is. A mentor doesn't go and stand in the booth for you. A mentor doesn't do weddings for you. But a mentor will help you to know, should you do 3 weddings in a week? Should you try to book 2 weddings on a Saturday? Have they tried it? What did they find out? Find out all the stuff that you can from a mentor, because that's what they're there for. They're not there to do the work for you. A mentor will also drive you up the wall, because they already know the mistakes that you're about to make. And if they're a good mentor, they will make sure that you're questioning those decisions before you get there, before you spend the money, before you commit yourself. They will say, do you really think it's a good time to go and spend X amount of dollars on new equipment when you've only booked 3 weddings for the next year? Do you think it's a good time to go and hire more staff people when you're only booked 1/2 the weddings last year and you didn't need 2nd photographers for them? Or maybe they will say, do you think maybe you should hire somebody to edit because you're so busy shooting weddings that you don't have the energy or the time during the week to do the other work. So they will challenge you in different areas. A mentor will not be in competition with you. So don't go and hire somebody in your city that's running the same business that you're about to run, because you'll run into huge problems. They will either direct you wrong, or they won't answer your questions truthfully, or they'll even steal your ideas. You want somebody that's going to help you build up your business. That's what a mentor is. A mentor is somebody that sees those mistakes and can help you with them before you get to that point. A mentor can sit down with you and go through your finances and say, look, I see that you've done great. You've made lots of money this month. But no, you cannot go out and spend $25,000 on new cameras because you don't have any weddings the rest of the year. And you need to pay rent. You need to do this. You need to do that. That's what a mentor's going to do. So if you want to learn photography, if you want to learn business, if you want to learn the ins and the outs, find somebody to be your mentor or your teacher, if you don't like the word mentor. I've done it for years. I've helped a lot of people. I've seen a lot of people do wonderful things, and they just needed a little bit of direction to get to where they were going. I've seen a lot of people in trouble that have come to me with big problems, and they were losing money, or they were in trouble because they had committed themselves to do something, they couldn't do it. And we sat down and we worked it out. That's what a mentor is to help you to do. In the nature and wildlife photography, I've helped lots of people start their businesses and run their businesses in those areas. They come to me and they say, oh, I think I'm just going to shoot stock. And we sit down, we figure out how much they have to shoot in order to make any good money in stock. And then I tell them that, you know, if you sold 2 prints a month, you'll make more than you could make in stock. And they go, really? Or I'll sit down with them and figure out the prices of what they're selling their stuff for and say, you know what? You're selling your stuff at a loss. If you sell it for this price, you'll actually be making money. And I can tell them different things that I've already experienced. A mentor can help in so many ways. So if you're looking at expanding your business, if you're looking at moving your business in a different direction, if you just want help with your every day-to-day things in your business, find yourself a good mentor and hire them. Now, how much should you spend for a mentor? Well, it varies. I have what I call my one-on-one sessions for $80 for 2 hours for the introductory. I tell people, if you don't know you want to get into it full scale, if you don't know if you want to get into it full time, pay for a couple 2 hour classes. Let us sit down. Let us go through some stuff. Let's figure some stuff out. That may be all you need. Or at the same time, you may say, wow, you've helped me so much. How about I pay you for every month? We'll sit down for 4 hours and we'll go through this stuff on the first Sunday of every month or the first Monday of every month, whatever it is. And we'll go through all of this stuff so I can set up my next month. And so I know where I'm going and I can solve the problems that I've run into in the last month. And then you can go from there. So it can cost you a little. It can cost you a lot. A mentor should not be a direct financial benefit. What do I mean by that? A mentor is not like going out and taking out an ad. Take out an ad, you know if that ad works. How? Because you make money off of that ad. A mentor is not going to be like that. A mentor is going to be somebody that will help you, that will give you ideas, and you may see financial gains, but they're not just there for the financial gains. They're there to make your work better. They're there to make your workflow better. They're there for you to save money. And yes, they are there for you to make money. So don't look at going out and spending $10,000 on a mentor is going to bring you in $75,000 in sales. It doesn't work that way. But if you spend $10,000 on a mentor, it may bring in $50,000 in sales over the year using their ideas. It may save you $25,000 in a year by using their ideas. It may stop you from getting into trouble in certain areas by using their ideas. So a mentor is not an ad. A mentor is not hiring an employee. A mentor is somebody to help you and to guide you. So until next time, get out there, take some great pictures. We'll talk to you soon.